Worried about condensate drain clogs, leaks, etc.? Stick around. I'm going to tell you how this blue little magical string will prevent condensate drain line clogs for 20 years. You're not going to believe it. Stick around. Smash that thumbs up button. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today we are taking out this 3-ton, I think it's a York, or it could be something else, but it's got a micro channel coil on the condensing unit, and you guys know those are notorious for leaks. A few years ago we added about 4 pounds of R22 to the system. Guess what? She's now low again. Customer made the smart decision in replacing the equipment. And today, I'm going to show you the proper practices on replacing equipment for your central air conditioning systems. All right, there's our unit. I have my recovery tank, recovery scale, my vacuum pump. I have my True Blue evacuation hoses. I only grabbed that because I wanted to grab my Schrader core removal tools that I'm going to use to pull out the Schrader cores out of both the low and high side, or the suction and the liquid lines. Okay, I'm gonna hook these up to there, remove those Schrader cores, because if I keep them in there, right, we're gonna prolong the recovery process. I remove the caps from the service port. I'm gonna open my valve. I'm gonna push in this plunger. And once I engage it, I'm gonna twist it in the counterclockwise orientation. There's gonna come a point where it's gonna wanna spit out at me, like that, because that's that high pressure, or the system refrigerant pressure, pushing out on that plunger. We're going to close the valve. We're going to unscrew this, and there is our Schrader core right there. This little doodad right here, right, these like to leak, similar to what you have on a car tire, right? Same exact thing. So it's very important that you put your caps back on when you're servicing equipment, because that's your first line of defense against the leak. And if you're, see, there's a refrigerant. We're gonna hook up our hoses, hook up our recovery machine, and start the recovery process. Let's be honest, guys. How many of you caught my mistake? I brought out the vacuum pump instead of the recovery machine. And there it is. So let's purge the air out of there. I have my R22 Testo 557 digital manifold. I have my high and low side hooked up to my service ports. I have my charging port, my charging hose hooked up to my recovery machine. I have everything open here and there. I'm going to put this to recover. I'm going to get some of that air out of there. Okay? So let's put our hose right on there. I'm just going to dry fit it on a little bit, like there. We're going to zero out our scale to zero. I'm going to open to recover, and we're going to purge out the air from the high and low side, through our manifold, through the charging hose, through the recovery machine, and through the recovery hose from the machine to our tank. I'm quite confident there is good. We're going to open this up fully, okay? And now we're going to start our recovery process. As you see, we don't have that much pressure in here, but still, it's good practice to recover. Both of my service valves, my king valves, are open. They're fully backseated. They're not closed. I'm recovering all the refrigerant, not only in the condensing coil, but also the line set and the evaporator coil inside the air handle located in the attic. Today, we're installing for this customer the Bosch IDS 2.1 connected IDS heat pump inverter system, air handler, outdoor condensing unit, our line sets, emergency drain pan, and we're also going to be using something for the first time on an installation, and that is we're going to be using the Prev Clog condensate drain line treatment system. It is a thin little rope that has like copper particles inside of it, but if it's installed properly at the initial installation, the manufacturer guarantees you will not have a clog for, not for 1 year, not for 2 years, not for 5 years, not for 10 years, but for 20 years. What's better than that, guys? And it's only a few minutes after we last spoke, but I'm already at 0 PSI of pressure. Let's start that up again. Let's make sure we're good there. We recovered a total of 0.5 pounds. Not a lot to write home about, but it is what it is. And it is also good practice to, if you're interested, to put a filter dryer on the line here going to the recovery machine. You'll protect the filters and screens inside your recovery machine, but you also will have more of a, I guess, cleaner refrigerant, you know, less dry, drier refrigerant. I don't have that on my little truck right there. Daniel does. Daniel, unfortunately, overslept this morning. At 7:30 in the morning, I'm like, yo, where's Daniel? And I check on my my GPS tracking system. I use GPS Track It. Link in the description box down below. And you can use gpstrackit.com/Mikey Pipes for a special offer off their services. Really cheap. And they also have dash cams, forward facing and cabin facing, for video and audio recording. So if you know you have a fleet of vehicles, or if it's just you and you want to have protection in case, you know, there are insurance con artists out there. They want to try to scam you, but if you got it on video, you're good. So I use GPS Track It. Not a paid endorsement, I use their products and I like it, and I think you should too. All right, there is the patient for the doctor. All right, I have my panels removed. I removed my blower. My line volt is still connected. I'm going to use my Fluke non-contact electrical tester just to get an audible warning when my breaker's off. So let's go head on down to the basement. I can probably hear this from the first floor, and maybe they'll help. Now it stopped? Excellent. Thank you. All right, so audibly, we're good. But let's get our Fluke 902FC multimeter from my Veto bag. Let's double check. All right, so I'm reading between L1 and L2, or line on my switch. I have no voltage. Then I'm gonna check the ground from each one. So L1 or L2 to a ground, also reading nothing. So I've safely confirmed that the power is off to the system, and now I can proceed with removing the electrical. All right, I have my return duct removed. I have my supply duct removed. Daniel arrived, and now we're sucking the water out of the emergency drain pan. Peter, if you're watching, or someone in Peter's family, or if one of Peter's friends who's watching this right now, please, someone put in the description box down below, in the comment section down below, why is Peter gone for 5 days for, let's call it a 12-hour wedding. Let's say they're really going to get plastered. I was going to say shit-faced. They really get plastered. Let's call it a 12-hour wedding. What if I hang over the next day? Why did Peter need 5 days off? Let's close our connection here. Let's close. Nothing there. And one thing we're going to do is that we're going to purge out the machine. Let's put that to self-purge. Start that off. A quick little purge on there. All right, I am going to put together back the air handler. Daniel was showing me the, oh my god, this condensing coil. And it should be a good habit to close the king valves, because if you don't close the king valves and you go up and over, you get this. Uncut, unedited, raw. That's vacuum, that's the oil from the compressor. And, what you should do real quick, you should get a garbage bag or a 5 gallon bucket with a scoop and just scoop that up, you know, cause that thing. Okay. All right. Back at the circuit breaker panel. There's the one we turned off, and I liked it to be better than the next guy. So there it is. Second floor, AHU, air handling unit. Turn that back on, and now we'll have blower. Get some air going in that attic.
Good. It's all yours.
And we're going to use the Zoomlock to coupling them together. Here's our end of our 3/4 ACR refrigeration tubing. We're cleaning the end of the piping, but we're preparing to use a Zoomlock reducing coupling right here. So Daniel's got a piece of emery paper, or what I refer to as scratchy paper. And we're having it slightly pitched down a little bit. Now he's got his deburring tool in his mouth. And we are going to deburr the inside of this pipe. Okay? So during deburring the pipe, you don't want to point it up or on the side, because then those little shavings are going to get in there. So now we have our RLS Zoom Lock right there. We have the reducing coupling right on top of the Bosch IDS 2.1 connected heat pump inverter outdoor unit. We are going to put that on there, and it has a little stop in there, I believe. If not, it'll make a fool out of me and you, and that would be. And there it is. She's never gonna go anywhere. And those seals, well, I put all my money in bet on them. For the past 20 minutes, the other Mike, who's Ollie over there, and I have been fishing, or trying to fish, this electrician's fish rope through 20 feet of 3/4 PVC drain piping to install this rope. And I gotta tell you, I don't think it's worth it. But let's see. So apparently, this stuff, which is embedded with some kind of minerals and metals, the main active ingredient, I believe, being copper, when you insert it through your condensate drain line from the evaporator to outdoors, it prevents all that sludge buildup, and it eats away that sludge, and it's guaranteed to not clog for a period of 20 years. There's the little string, as you can see. It goes all the way from the exterior, following roughly around 20 feet of 3/4 inch PVC into my clear trap, and then through my clear trap, and then back into the evaporator. You gotta love it when you see the original wallpaper from the 1920s in the wall. See, it has nice little, like a little fabric, like a little rubberized little, I don't know, squishy thing there. It keeps any drafts from affecting the operation of the thermostat. You never know, you could have a draft inside the wall.
It'd be nice if it had a level.
Play, let it play out for a minute. Doom, doom.
Boom. You're gonna get copyright.
Yeah. So you know, you thought the wall is gone, right? The wall's gone right there. It's not gone right here. And this is plaster, right? So watch what we do. Now, I am gonna be like MacGyver. I'm gonna put a screw right there. And I am gonna penetrate the plaster. And behind that plaster, we have that wood lath. And this screw is gonna get to that wood lath. Smash that thermostat against that base plate like you're gonna smash the thumbs up button right now. Oh, is it hitting my little screw right there?
Oh, yeah, that is.
Oh, no, tell me it's not hitting the little. Is it?
Yeah.
In case you're just tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, we're shaving the back of the Bosch BCC100 thermostat to accommodate that screw, which really doesn't make any sense. It's probably the wall not being level in this house from the 1840s. Yep.
That's pretty good.
One complaint that you're going to get when you install the Bosch IDS 2.1 series, people are going to complain that they don't think it's on because it makes no noise. We're literally right in front of it, and she's making no noise. Okay, full disclosure, there's model and serial number. There's our nice line set that comes up, across, and then up to the attic. Oh, and we added surge protection. There it is, the Rector seal, the RSH50, right? Surge protector. Here's Adam, here's the homeowner. Very nice, we've been servicing your property for a number of years. We also service your in-laws property in Atlantic Beach. We're like a fixture of the home, right? What made you, or what was the deciding factor? Because you had plenty of choices. We could have went with a Carrier, we could have went with a Bosch, you could have went with the Carrier Infinity, but you went with the Bosch inverter heat pump. I gotta ask why.
The Bosch offers incredible value at an ultra efficient variable speed technology and at comparable rates compared to the other units I've seen. The warranty's unmatchable, and you can't hear a sound from the unit.
Thank you so much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe. Smash that thumbs up button and consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. Do it now.